2025 is the year of AI agents, and if you're not already using them, you're falling behind. In this video, I'll show you why ChatLLM Teams is the perfect starting point to unlock the future of automation in intelligent workflows. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. I do believe this is the year where you'll see AI agents creep into the workforce. It excites me to find a product that allows users to test and learn what these agents are all about and see what the possibilities are. ChatLLM Teams gives you that access. I want to show you two different ways to connect to agents today. The first one's going to be through a computer agent where you're going to see you can direct an agent to take over a computer to perform tasks. The other will be creating your own agent with the help from an AI engineer. Let's get started. I'm logged in to ChatLLM here, and this is where I'm going to access the computer agent and how to create your own agent. I want to point out a strength of ChatLLM, and if I drop down right here, look at this. You have access to all the leading models right here under one place. So if you're into coding, you have Sonnet here. If you want something with high reasoning, O1. If you want something with video analysis, we have Gemini 2.0. All of them in one place with ChatLLM. The impressive thing is, though, it's only $10 a month for all of this. And I have subscriptions to these other ones that cost me a lot more than that. So the link's down below in the description if you want to take advantage of this. Now, the other thing I want to point out right before I get started with the agents is if I go and I'm just going to click on this, take a look with creating an image. You have all the different image models of these ones right here when you're creating your image. Also, a cool feature is if I go back over here to more, you can do video generation here. So if I go ahead and put a text in for prompt, I can use one of these different ones right here to create a video. I'm going to have a different video showing all these different things about ChatLLM. I'll put the link down below in the description and up above in the card. But for now, let's go over to the start with our computer agent right here. To explain what you're seeing here, this is a virtual machine over here. So if I go down here, click on Firefox, it will open up just like a regular computer. I can do a search within here. So if I was looking for vacations, I could go ahead and click and do all this. I can close it down. It has LibreOffice on it. I could go ahead, open up a spreadsheet and work on it. So this is what the AI agent will be controlling. So I'm just going to close out of this. And when I ask it to do something, everything that you see being opened will be by the AI agent. And I'm going to give you a couple different examples. So over here, this is where we're going to chat with the agent. And I'm just going to click on this first one. And then I'm going to create my own prompt to give it. Down here, there's some tips and tricks about your creating your prompt and everything. So it's good to check that out as well. But let's do this one. Find and download an image of Machu Picchu. So it has multiple steps there. And what it does first that you're going to notice, it lays out the steps. So first, let's take a screenshot so it knows where it's going to open up of the desktop. It's going to open Firefox. Right now, it's being fully controlled by the AI agent. It's going to do a search for Machu Picchu pictures. And right here on the left, right here, you can see this is where you'll see the step-by-step that it's doing. So it went to Wikipedia this time, and I've done this a few different times, and it can change how it does it each time. Sometimes it just goes to Google and through Google Images and found it that way and downloaded. This time it's going to Wikipedia. Now with the prompt, you can direct it specifically, go to a spot if you want to grab the picture from there too. But I like what they're doing this time because they're downloading the high resolution picture here that they'll do. And if I scroll on the down on the side, you can see the step-by-step that it's going through. So now it's going to click on download button to save the original file. And then I'm going to have this file on my computer. I just went and clicked on new session up top. It will clear it. So now I'm going to give it a few things to do. And I'm just going to paste my prompt in. It's going to be find the top five most watched series on Netflix in 2024. Create a web page with the data from some interesting facts. Show a graph of the data. So it's going to have to search for this information. Then it's going to create an HTML page and create the chart inside this HTML page, put some facts. Let's see if it can handle this. Now, again, I've done this a few different times, changed my prompt slightly. Sometimes I get them get it to put the data inside the spreadsheet that is on LibreOffice here, and it puts it in and it can chart that way. I've even asked it to make PowerPoints. This is a little bit faster, this one. This is why I'm showing you here. And sometimes it shows me the coding as it goes along, but probably in this one it won't. It's just going to pop up and have the finished web page. If I look over on the side over here, you can see it's going to research the data. It's going to create the HTML file, use ChartJS for visualization, and open in Firefox to verify it. So a lot of this is happening behind the scenes. Like I said, sometimes it shows it right. It shows the code as it's going along here. But you can see where it's at. Now let's enter the local path. This is where it's saved on my computer right here. This temp, not on my computer, but on the virtual machine here in this temp file. So it went through. You can see as I hover over, it's interactive. As I hover over and see the different information, if I go down here, it has some interesting facts. Like I said, I could ask it again and it might do this in a different way. So when you're prompting it, you want to try to be as exact as you want, be short, concise, but try to get the steps that you know you want. Maybe you wanted to go to a certain website to grab the information. I wasn't that specific, but this, you can see as this moves forward with the AI agents, you're just going to be asking things to get created. And I can go back and prompt it here to add in more points to it or to do something else to it. Let's go create an AI agent now. And I'm going to drop down and go to the AI engineer. And this is a wizard that's going to help you create these. So when I go to this, notice that we can create a custom chat bot or create an AI agent. And this is in beta. I'm going to choose this one. So when I pick this one, you're going to notice that you have different options here. You can create the ones they've suggested right here, or use the custom one. And all you'd have to do is give it a name and then give it some details what you want it to create. And I've tried it a few different times at different levels of success. So maybe I would change what I was asking it to do. But I'm going to do this one right here, this news reporter agent, and it's going to summarize and provide insights about the latest news given a topic. So I'm just going to go ahead and submit this, and then it submits the form, and then you're going to see that it will execute code, and it takes about probably like 3-4 minutes for it to get done, and then I'll show you the results. So this is what happened. As I said, it took about probably like 3 minutes, but then you watch this information come up and the coding and the execution comes up and it goes through and it will test it at different levels. So it executes the code, see if what the results are. It lets you know here at this point, you know, great, it was working successfully, and it keeps on going down, testing it at different levels. Then it deploys the agent, and then you can see where you can access it. So there's a couple links down here. We can access it right here and we can edit it. And I'll show you where the edit is in a moment, but let's go ahead and access it and try it out. Let's give it a topic here. So I'm gonna type in NFL because I've been following on my phone the Chiefs game and the Houston Texans. And I believe it's in the second quarter right now. Last time I checked, it was 6-3. Let's see if they come up with any news here. And it looks like they do have a score that I just noticed on my phone too. So the Chiefs in Texas, it's right now 6-3 early in the second quarter. And that's what it was just a moment ago when I checked it. So you can see it's very accurate with live time, gave a lot of other information that's trending in the NFL. Now over on the left, we have, these are gonna be my different searches. As I do more, you'll see more come up. I can delete them, edit. If I drop down here, notice we have a custom bot now. This is our news reporter agent app that we just created here. If I go back to the AI engineer, notice it's right over here too as well, the agent that we just created. I want to point out too, the agent platforms. If I go ahead and click on this, this is where the agents are going to live. So this is where they're going to get stored. And if you want to delete them, this is where you would go ahead and do this. Now you could create a project from this point. For me, I like using the wizard to set everything up, but you can always go back. If I click on it, you can see all the different steps that are in it that you can go and tweak it at this level, or like I said, create from scratch. I hope you have enjoyed this tour of the agents in ChatLLM Teams. It's such a great way to access all these features in one place. Make sure you check out that other video I have coming about ChatLLM Teams, where I look at all the other great features that it has. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.